So, I know it can be difficult for you to understand and sound just like native speakers. Well, stand by, in this video, I'll show you what's happening.
Let's go.
Thank you for joining English Booster with Ben. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're new here. Now, in this video, I want to teach you about the number one thing that you need to start paying attention to understand fast native speakers and to sound just like them. And even as a beginner, intermediate, or advanced English learner, this is a very good lesson for you. Because you may have taken lots of English classes, studied lots of grammar rules, or maybe you've lived in an English-speaking country for years, but still having a hard time understanding native speakers, moreover to sound like them. Well, I want to show you the number one thing that native speakers use that make them sound really fast, and also how using that can make you sound very confident as you speak English. So, do you want to know how it works?
Say what?
What?
Right, that's what I'm talking about. I mean, do you want to know how it works? Guys, it is simply the use of linguistic reduction. I know, right? No worries, I got your back. So, what is reduction in language? Maybe you already have an idea about the fact that reduction stands for something that gets shorter. In language, it's not quite different. In fact, reduction is just the loss of sounds in words. Basically, sounds that you're supposed to hear in words but are just cut off. Here's an example. I didn't know that you'd come over for dinner. Did you hear what's being said? The speakers are just saying, I did not know that you would come over for dinner. You may be very familiar with the reductions being used in that sentence. Maybe you noticed already what is one way that words can get reduced. Sounds in words tend to get shorter, which of course makes some people, more specifically native speakers, sound really fast. Have you guessed already? That is correct. It is the use of contraction. Well, contraction can easily be defined as a word or a word group that has been shortened by dropping one or more letters. As a result, the word becomes shorter. In normal conversation, there is a high expectation that you will hear contraction words, and this as often as possible. Because not only it helps saving time, but also it makes the conversation sound a little bit more friendly, or let's say more relaxed. And that's why, in most TV shows and pop music, you'll get to hear lots of contraction words. Since we're talking about entertainment and contraction, let's take a look at some contraction words in the following video.
Do you really think I can be happy?
Of course! It's inside you! It's inside of all of us! And I don't think it. I feel it.
Right, this contraction words are pretty easy to read, to write, and hear in conversations. But here's when it gets interesting. Here we go. I know you couldn't stop the feeling, could you? Well, as I said, this part is interesting, not because of the contraction words shouldn't and can't, but because of this special contraction word ain't. Although you get to hear this contraction word in some TV shows and most pop music, it's still not grammatically correct. Now, more interestingly, just the word ain't has different meanings. It can mean am not, is not, or not, has not, or have not. Okay, let's see if you can identify the meaning of the word ain't in the following videos. Here we go.
it is important to highlight how contraction words, as a common type of reduction, are mostly used in informal language. And this, whether it is written, like in some text messages, or some informal emails, or spoken English, like in some casual conversations, friendly talks, or any situation that involves people that we know pretty well. However, in serious occasions like in presentation, business meetings, a job interview, or anywhere that you like to sound professional, or let's say knowledgeable, you wouldn't want to use reduction much. You would not want to use reduction much, or at all, for words like ain't or gone. Which leads us to another type of reduction. Remember that reductions are sounds in word that may change and disappear when spoken at normal speed, which is why you may not understand fast native speakers sometimes. Another example of reduction is when the word to is placed after a verb, like going. It is barely pronounced. So if we have going to, for example, which indicates the future, that something is most likely gonna happen. So rather than having going to, it will sound like gonna. For instance, she's not going to come to work today. Here, we have some contractions as well as the reduction going to, which is something like this. She is not going to come to work today. Here's another example. This is not going to work. Slowly, it would sound like this. This is not going to work. Interestingly, some people may even say like this. This ain't gonna work. Remember that the contraction word ain't can also mean is not. So some people may use the word ain't in that case. But remember, it is important that you get familiar with how they sound as well as their original written form. Because they're mostly used in movies, lyrics, and any other kinds of entertainment, let's check out the reduction gonna and some videos.
So what?
So it's not gonna be easy. It's gonna be really hard. And we're gonna have to work at this every day, but I wanna do that because I want you. I want all of you, forever, you and me, every day.
This is when it gets too emotional. But you could see how quickly and naturally the words were coming out. As the character was using some contraction words, as well as the reduction, gonna. Let's play it once more.
So what?
So it's not gonna be easy. It's gonna be really hard. We're gonna have to work at this every day, but I wanna do that because I want you.
We also get another reduction when the word to is placed after the verb want. So, want to becomes wanna, which is used to tell about something that you want to do. Like, I want to start learning a new language. I want to start learning a new language. Oh, it is one more thing that I want to do.
Party in Ipanema, baby. I want a party. I want a song. I want a party. I want a song. I want a party. And live my life.
My life.
I want a party.
Party.
And fly.
Let's say there are many other reductions when to is placed after a verb. For example, have to would most likely sound as have to. Like in the sentence, I have to go home now. Interestingly, the verb got, when followed by to, gets further reduced as gotta, which also means the same as have to. They are both used to explain that something is necessary. We can use that same example, I gotta go home now. So, the bottom line is that the English that you have learned at school can be very different from the English that you'll hear in conversations. And this is not because people are using different words, but a big reason behind this is because in spoken English, the words do not always sound the same as they would be written. But instead, sounds and words tend to change and disappear when spoken at normal speed, which we call linguistic redaction. Know that there are many other redactions. Most of them would be found at the beginning of a question. Here's a list of some everyday American English questions. Do you want to help me? Are you going to help me? Can you? Could you? Would you? Did you? Don't you? And so on. Great job now, since you made it until the end of this video, which was just an introduction to our series, Understand and Speak English Like Native Speakers. Now, remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell for our next lessons. I will see you in the next video.